Question number 10. A guy wire is attached to a vertical pole of height 18 meter is 24 meter long and has a stake attached to the other end. How far from the base of the pole should the stake be driven so that the wire will be taut? So situation is like this. Start by writing solution. This problem is very much similar to previous problem. I will give you the diagram here. I will explain what it is. You have to take it as homework. Done. What is this? This is ground now. On this ground, 18 meter high pole is standing. This is 18 meter high pole. To this, a guy wire is attached and it is pulled so that it is tight enough like this. Then it is buried inside. Its other end is buried inside by tying it to a stake. This is stake here inside the ground. For us, actually, it is a triangle, right angle triangle. Other words are not important for us, right? So now let us call this as triangle ABC. What is this? This is guy wire, 24 meter long. Here you are having ground, having ground. Now you have to find what is BC. Find what is BC. Is it not very much similar to previous problem? In place of wall, pole has come. In place of ladder, wire has come. You have to find the distance between wall and the stake that is buried in the ground. So this is stake here. You will be having a hook here. To that hook, it will be tied. I hope you have seen such guy wires attached to the electrical poles. You take it as homework. Okay. Now we will take question number 11. An aeroplane leaves an airport and flies. Yeah. Due north at a speed of 100 km per hour. At the same time, another aeroplane leaves the same airport and flies due west. So these directions are very important for us. North and west. At a speed of 1200 km per hour, how far apart will be the two planes after 1.5 hour? What is the angle between north direction and west direction? Ninety degree, right? Very good. So I'll start solving this. All right, solution. Let us say here is airport now. Airport. Okay. From the airport, one plane goes in north direction. Now I am facing north, so I am showing it like this. Let us call this as plane P. Let us call this as plane P. Another plane goes in the west direction. I will call it as Q. Airport I will call as R. Airport I will call as R. So the angle between the directions of aeroplanes is now 90 degree. You have to find the distance between the planes after 1.5 hour. How far the two planes will be after 1.5 hour? Assume that both planes are flying at same height. Okay, actually that should be mentioned in the question, it is not mentioned. We have to assume that the two planes are flying at the same height. Okay. Let us call this as north direction and this says west direction. Let plane P, let plane P flies in north direction. North direction at a speed of 1,000 km/h. 1,000 km/h. The distance covered by plane P in 1.5 hour we have to take. In 1.5 hour. What is that distance for us in figure? PR. How do you calculate distance when speed and time are known? Distance is equal to speed into time. So 1000 into 1.5 hour, this will become 1500 kilometers. 1500 kilometers. All right here. And plane Q flies in west direction, in west direction, at a speed of 1200 kilometer per hour, per hour. Okay. The distance covered by the distance covered by plane Q, what is the notation for it then? QR is equal to 1200 into 1.5 hour. This will be equal to 1800 kilometer. This will be equal to 1800 kilometer. Have you all written? Angle between directions of angle between directions of two planes is 90 degree, is 90 degree. Then write here, refer to figure above. Refer to figure above. So now I will write here 1500 kilometer. And here I will write 1800 kilometer. Now angle between the directions of two planes is 90 degree. So we can apply Pythagoras theorem to this triangle PQR. And then find what is PQ as hypotenuse. Applying Pythagoras theorem, PR square is 1500 square. This should be QR. And here you should have 1800 square. Fifteen square is 225. Two zeros in the number means in square you will be having four zeros. Plus 18 square is 324. And along with that, four zeros now. So this is PQ square. Add these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 plus 4, 9, 2 plus 2, 4, 2 plus 3, 5. 5, 4, 9, 4 zeros. PQ is 549 four zeros under square root. How will you find square root? By division method. To find by division method. There are four zeros in the square means there will be two zeros in your answer. That is square root of 549 four zeros. So let us try that here now. Five, four, nine. Group these. Two twos are four. One here. Add two here, you get four. Take 49 down. It is 149. 43 threes are you have to try because 44 fours will be more than 1600. 44 fours will be more than 160, right? So take 43. 43 into 3. 43 into 3. Nine. 3 fours are 12. What do you get? 129. Add 3 here. You get 46. 0, 2, 0. Take 2 zeros. Down. This one zero is there now. You will get one more zero here. 460. One jar, two jar, three jar. Paisa you cannot take because 405 paisa you will get 2000 plus you will get. You try with 464 forja. 464 forja. I think someone is sitting with calculator there. He is giving answer directly. It should not happen. 4 forja 16. 6 fours are 24 plus 125. 4 fours are 16 plus 2, 18. We get 1856. And what you have to write here? Forja. And here also you have to write 4. Now add 4 here. 4, 4, 1, 0. Now another set of zeros you have to take down. 0, 0. So this becomes 468. 468. 468, it's less than 20,000. We'll have to take, even it is less than 16,000. So to take here 3 only. 468 threes are, let us try. 4 6 8 3 threes are 3 threes are 9, 3 8s are 24. Then 3 6s are 18 plus 2 20. 3 4s are 12 plus 2 14. Very good. One 4 0 4 9. 1 5 3 0 0 351 you got. So this three have to show here. This three have to show here. Okay. Next, what happens? You have to place a point. Then you have to take two more zeros here. That means two more zeros will come down here. So add 3 to this. 4, 6, 8, 3, 8, 6, it will become. We will stop here because the distance is in 1000 kilometers, thousands of kilometers, right? Thousands of kilometers. So in that, few meters will not make much difference. Few meters or few centimeters will not make much difference. So for this, we'll write answer as 2343 kilometers approximately, approximately. Now right here, after one and half hour, planes can fly, trains cannot fly, is it right? Planes P and Q, planes P and Q will be 2343 kilometer far apart. Far apart. If I place a point here and if I want to continue, then I will have to put point here and then take two zeros. Right? But we are not going for that. We stopped after getting very accurate answer, right? Very close to the accurate answer, in fact.